attitude, we're all tiptoeing, trying to like navigate the PC culture, and I think this is time for us to stop and go, look, we care about people, we want to be sensitive, there's certainly things we can learn and do differently. But we love God, and we love our families, and we love our freedom. And we're going to continue to worship, we're going to continue to keep God a priority, we're going to continue some basics. Because any sense I don't do that, I'm want to cancel culture. I want to remember. Does that mean we can't do some things different? No, we can still learn and we can still grow. We can still make a more perfect union. That's our goal, right? We haven't arrived. No one in the U.S. thinks we've got it down. But the most important thing is that we don't forget God. If tomorrow all the things are gone and that I've worked for all my life and I had to start again, just like someone, that gorgeous life, I think for those on our Zoom call, one day we're going to be able to pipe in with you, so you'll be able to, we'll be able to hear you in the sanctuary, which will be cool, but we're not there technically yet, but we'll get there, and we'll be able to journey with you. Well, really good being with you today. I think you got the point, and the point is simply we live in a provocative time where people want to cancel certain things out. They want to cancel prayer in schools. They want to cancel Bible reading. They want to cancel all memory of what God has done in our history, and they want to cancel our heroes like Washington and Lincoln. Once you eliminate all that, what do you have? Chaos, disorder, weakness, nothing. And, you know, I'm grateful we live in this amazing